Hello, acute angels. This is Teacher Anna, and welcome to another Matinique episode. Today, we will talk about measures of position for ungrouped data. Are you ready? Well, at the end of this lesson, you are expected to illustrate the following measures of position: quartiles, deciles, and percentiles. Calculates a specified measure of position, for example, the 90th percentile of a set of data. Interprets measures of position and solves problems involving measures of position. What are measures of position? Measures of position give us a way to see where a certain data point or value falls in a sample or distribution. A measure can tell us whether a value is above the average or whether it's unusually high or low. Measures of position are used for quantitative data that falls on some numerical scale. Sometimes, measures can be applied to ordinal variables, those variables that have an order, like first, second, and 50th. How about the ungrouped data? Ungrouped data is the data collected in original form. We can say that ungrouped data is an array of numbers. For instance, you take on a survey, the raw answers you get are the ungrouped data. For example, we have 1, 5, 4, 6, 4, 3, 2, 1, 7, and 3. Under measures of position, we have three types: the quartile, the decile, and the percentile. Let's talk on the quartile for ungrouped data first. The quartiles are the score points which divide a distribution into four equal parts. It means the data are divided into four equal parts. And as you see, we have three score points in the figure. We have quartile 1, quartile 2, and quartile 3. When we say quartile 1, 25% of the data has a value less than or equal to quartile 1. And when we say quartile 2, 50% of the data has a value of less than or equal to quartile 2. And for quartile 3, we have 75% of the data has a value of less than or equal to quartile 3. Also, when we say quartile 1, it is also considered as the lower quartile. For quartile 2, since it is in the middle, we call it as the median. Quartile 3 is called the upper quartile. And when we get the difference of Q3 and Q1, we called it as the interquartile range. Next, we have the decile for ungrouped data. The deciles are the 9 score points which divide a distribution into 10 equal parts. It means the data are divided into 10 equal parts. For example, we have decile 1, decile 2, decile 3, decile 4, decile 5, decile 6, decile 7, decile 8, and decile 9 as the score points. Lastly, we have the percentile for ungrouped data. The percentiles are the 99 score points which divide a distribution into 100 equal parts, so that each part represents the data set. If we compare it to the quartile, quartile 1 will serve as percentile 25. Quartile 2 will be percentile 50. Quartile 3 will be percentile 75. And if we compare percentile to the decile, decile 1 will serve as percentile 10. Decile 2 will be percentile 20. Decile 3 will serve as percentile 30. Decile 4 is percentile 40, decile 5 is percentile 50, decile 6 is percentile 60, decile 7 is percentile 70, and decile 8 is percentile 80, Lastly, decile 9 is percentile 19. So, how do we solve measures of position? Well, we have two methods of finding the measures of position. The first method is the Mendenhall and Sinsich method. In here, we calculate the position of the given quartile, decile, or percentile. Here are the formula. For the position of Q sub K, we have K over 4 multiplied to the quantity N plus 1. For the position of D sub K, we have K over 10 multiplied to the quantity N plus 1. And for percentile, we have P sub K is equal to K over 100 multiplied to N plus 1. K's are the unknown. If you are looking for quartile 1, then K is 1. If you are looking for decile 5, then K is 5. And if you are looking for percentile 17, then K is 17. While N, on the other hand, are the total number of data in a given set. Another note about Mendenhall and Sinsich method, if you are calculating measures of position that falls on the left side of the median, medians are the following: quartile 2, decile 5, and percentile 50. We round up. But if it falls on the right side, we round down. Let's have an example. Example number 1, find the quartile 1, decile 7, and percentile 88 of the following test scores of 9 students in their mathematics activity. 1, 27, 16, 7, 31, 7, 30, 3, and 21. The first step in identifying the measures of position in the Mendenhall and Sinsich method is to arrange the scores in ascending order. We have 1, 3, 7, 7, 16, 21, 27, 30, and 31. Then for step 2, that would be the time for us to solve or calculate the measures of position. Let's solve for quartile 1 first. For quartile 1, our formula would be position of Q sub K is equal to K over 4 multiplied to the quantity N plus 1. The value of K is 1 and the value of N is 9 since we have 9 students. So we have position of Q sub 1 is equal to 1 over 4 multiplied to the quantity 9 plus 1. 9 plus 1 is equal to 10. Then we have 1 over 4 multiplied to 10 is equal to 2.5. And since it falls on the left side of the median, quartile 1 will be 3 since we need to round up. The computed value 2.5 becomes 3 after rounding up. The lower quartile value Q sub 1 is the third data element. So we count 3 on the given data. So we have 1, 2, 3. The third data element is 7. So quartile 1 is equal to 7. Therefore, 25% of the test scores of 9 students in their mathematics activity are less than or equal to 7. Since we already arranged the data in ascending order, we proceed to the computation of decile 7. For the decile, our formula would be position of D sub K is equal to K over 10 multiplied to N plus 1. The value of K is 7 and again the value of N is 9. Substituting it to the given formula, we have position of D sub 7 is equal to 7 over 10 multiplied to the quantity 9 plus 1. 9 plus 1 is equal to 10. So we have 7 over 10 multiplied to 10, which is equal to 7. Since the calculated measures of position is already in whole number, we just need to count the data elements in ascending order. The value of decile 7 or D7 is the 7th data element. And the 7th element in the given data is 27. Therefore, decile 7 is equal to 27. It means 70% of the test scores of 9 students in their mathematics activity are less than or equal to 27. We now proceed to the computation of percentile 88. For percentile, our formula would be position of P sub K is equal to K over 100 multiplied to N plus 1. The value of K is equal to 88 and the value of N is 9. Substituting it to the formula, we have 88 over 100 multiplied to 9 plus 1. 9 plus 1 is 10. So we have 88 over 100 multiplied to 10, which is equal to 8.8. And since percentile 88 falls on the right side of the median, we need to round down. From 8.8, we have 8. The value of percentile 88 or P88 is the 8th data element. And that 8th element is 30. So percentile 88 is equal to 30. Therefore, 88% of the test scores of 9 students in their mathematics activity are less than or equal to 30. And that's how we calculate using the Mendenhall and Sensich method. Just note that using this method, the values of the calculated measures of position are always on the data element. And the second method in identifying the measures of position is the linear interpolation. Interpolation is the process of finding a value between two points on a line or curve. In order to understand what it means, think of the first part of the word, which is inter, as meaning enter, or for us to look inside the data we originally had. It is like getting the exact value of the measures of position. It means the value may or may not appear on the given data elements. Here are the steps in identifying measures of position using linear interpolation. Step 1. Arrange the data in ascending order. Step 2. Locate the position of the score in the distribution using the following formula. For the position of Q sub K, we have K over 4 multiplied to N plus 1. For decile, we have K over 10 multiplied to N plus 1. And for percentile, we have K over 100 multiplied to N plus 1. If the result is a decimal number, proceed for the interpolation. Here are the steps of interpolation. Step 1. Find the difference between the two values wherein Q sub K, D sub K, or P sub K is situated. Step 2. Multiply the result by the decimal obtained in step 2 in identifying the quartile using linear interpolation. And step 3. Add the result in the smaller number in step 1. To better understand it, let's have some examples. For example, find the quartile 1, decile 7, and percentile 88 of the following test scores of 9 students in their mathematics activity. 1, 27, 16, 7, 31, 7, 30, 3, and 21. Step 1. Arrange the scores in ascending order. The arrangement would be 1, 3, 7, 7, 16, 21, 27, 30, and 31. And for step 2, locate the position of the score in the distribution. We will be using the formula for quartile. Q sub K is equal to K over 4 multiplied to N plus 1. The value of K is 1 and the value of N is 9. So we have 1 over 4 multiplied to 9 plus 1. 9 plus 1 is equal to 10. So we have 1 over 4 multiplied to 10, which is equal to 2.5. For step 3, if the result is a decimal number, proceed for the interpolation. Since the result is a decimal number, 2.5, interpolation is needed. So for the interpolation, our step number one would be find the difference between the two values wherein Q sub k is situated. Q sub k is equal to 2.5, and the 2.5 element is in between 3 and 7. So we get their difference. We have 7 minus 3, which is equal to 4. For step 2, multiply the result by the decimal obtained in step 2 in identifying the quartile using linear interpolation. So we have 4 multiplied to the decimal in 2.5, we have 0.5, which is equal to 2. And for the last step, add the result in the smaller number in step 1. The smaller number in step 1 is 3. So we have 3 plus 2 is equal to 5. So the value of quartile 1 is equal to 5. Therefore, 25% of the test scores of 9 students in their mathematics activity are less than or equal to 5. Since we already arranged the scores in ascending order, we now proceed to the computation of decile 7. For decile, our formula would be position of d sub k is equal to k over 10 multiplied to n plus 1. The value of k is 7 and the value of n is 9. We have 7 over 10 multiplied to 9 plus 1. 9 plus 1 is equal to 10. So we have 7 over 10 multiplied to 10, which is equal to 7. For step 3, if the result is a decimal number, proceed for the interpolation. Since the result is not a decimal number, interpolation is not needed. So we just get the value of decile 7 by identifying the 7th data element. So the 7th data element in the ascending order of the data is 27. So decile 7 is equal to 27. Therefore, 70% of the test scores of 9 students in their mathematics activity are less than or equal to 27. For the last one, we need to identify percentile 88. The formula for the percentile is position of P sub k is equal to k over 100 multiplied to the quantity n plus 1. The value of k is 88 and the value of n is 9. So we have 88 over 100 multiplied to 9 plus 1. 9 plus 1 is equal to 10. So we have 88 over 100 multiplied to 10, which is equal to 8.8. For step 3, if the result is a decimal number, proceed for the interpolation. Since the result is a decimal number, 8.8, interpolation is needed. The step 1 in interpolation is to find the difference between the two values wherein P sub k is situated. P sub 88 is in between 30 and 31 because it is in the 8.8 element. Getting the difference, we have 31 minus 30, which is equal to 1. And for step 2, multiply the result by the decimal obtained in step 2 in identifying the quartile using linear interpolation. We have 1 multiplied to 0.8, the decimal in 8.8, which is equal to 0.8. For step 3, add the result in the smaller number in step 1. The smaller number in step 1 is 30. So we have 30 plus 0.8, which is equal to 30.8. So percentile 88 is equal to 30.8. Therefore, 88% of the test scores of 9 students in their mathematics activity are less than or equal to 30.8. And that's how we solve measures of position using linear interpolation. Just remember, when we say quartile, the data are divided into 4 equal parts. And when we say decile, the data are divided into 10 equal parts. And when we say percentile, the data are divided into 100 equal parts. Dear Acute Angels, you did great in watching and listening. I hope you are now confident to answer activities related to it. Again, this is Teacher Anna, and see you on another Matinique episode.